Welcome everyone. Thank you for joining us for today's webinar. My name is Abhilash and I am the Marketing Executive at CAD Technologies. Just a little housekeeping before we get started. If you have any questions during the presentation, please type them into the question box in your GoToWebinar control panel. I'll bring them up during the presentation and we will also have time for questions at the end. There is also a viewer window on the left. This window will show you the presentation that we are sharing from our screen. You also have access to a control panel that is on the right hand side from where you can share your comments. The webinar is also being recorded and everyone will receive an email with a link to view a recording of today's event. Now let me introduce you to our presenter for today. Our presenter for today is Shruti Nair. She is a software developer with 3.5 years of experience. Shruti specializes in hybrid mobile applications using PhoneGap, Cordova, JavaScript, and HTML5. She has completed her MCA from Gautam Buddha Technical University in 2012. To begin with, I would like to introduce you to our company, CAD Technologies. CAD is a fast-growing digital transformation solutions company that helps enterprises rebuild their customer experience for a digital consumer. With our niche and rich expertise in a wide range of technologies and services like CMS, CRM, e-commerce, cloud, IoT, data analytics, and product engineering, we help companies leverage their best on-web cloud mobile platforms. We enable you to create insights-driven customer engagement across all touch points to build a unified marketing approach. Our custom technology solutions have been deployed successfully in companies across the globe, especially in the US, Europe, and Australia. You can use the hashtags and handles to post questions, follow us, or even tag us, and post your questions as well. Now, without further delay, I'll hand it over to our speaker for today. Over to you, Shruti.
Thank you, Abhilash. A brief introduction. Let's start about the wearable technologies. So we've all used or seen wearables being used to count our steps, to keep a track of our heartbeats. So wearables have become a part of our daily lives. There are a few industries such as manufacturing and healthcare that have started leveraging the benefits of wearables to gain more efficiencies in their business. Wearables in manufacturing, what is the potential of wearables in manufacturing industries and how they are going to change the way manufacturing industries work? So let's start by looking at some market research. Research firm Strategy Analytics predict massive surge in the wearable industry, with the revenue in the global wearable devices market expected to reach $37 billion in 2020 from $1 billion in 2014. Similarly, Juniper Research predicts shipments of wearable devices to be almost 130 million by 2018. So what are the wearables we are talking about and what all manufacturing devices cover? Wearables include smart watches or tags, smart glasses, gloves, and sensors, which are fitted to a garment such as a vest to monitor. Manufacturing industries such as mining, oil and gas, distinct production industries such as companies manufacturing cars, airplanes, toys, continuous production industries like oil refining, pulp, metal smelting and all. And then there is the supply chain moving goods, products and services from suppliers to customers. Wearable devices such as smart glasses, smart watches are an emerging breed of mobile technology that has the potential to contribute manufacturing outputs by giving the workforce a direct interface to the smart systems and automation investments around them. Smart glasses are considered the most powerful of the wearable devices and enable manufacturing workforce to receive information and alerts from enterprise networks while remaining hands-on with their work. So next will be how wearables are impacting the manufacturing industry. Wearables have Wearables are transforming the manufacturing process, improving productivity, increasing efficiencies, and enhancing employee engagements. Wearables have the capacity of transforming manufacturing process by affecting the security of employees, scheduling of shifts, and monitoring the product design and development, shop floor operations to workers' training and safety, and thus wearables have potential to play a major role in the entire value chain. Imagine some interesting scenarios on the shop floor. Think of a quality inspector with smart glass or other wearable technologies walking the production line and seeing live performance metrics about the actual running process he's looking at. The inspector could call up any relevant information, perhaps by voice commands or by eye movement, to see specifications, defect patterns, or anything else desired. Another application might be in the warehouse, where workers could see maps with location of any item needed, as well as where to deliver it. This could reduce the time wastage in moving supplies and could greatly add to the just-in-time manufacturing schemes. It might even be possible to add some kind of learning capability to these applications so that the user experience becomes more and more personalized and helpful over time, thus enhancing the employee's engagement. Next, we'll be looking at some benefits that wearables provide to the manufacturing industries to attain efficiencies. First is scheduling and time logging. Wearables allow employees to automatically punch in or punch out from their shifts using the smart wristbands. Wearables allow managers to assign work and monitor the work assigned to the employees. Manage shifts. Wearables allow managers as well as employees to manage their shifts based on changing requirements. Wearables can be used to automatically punch in or punch out employees. How is this done? The Shift Expert app by Click Software is a mobile app that helps in employee scheduling and maximizing the staff efficiency. The app can be synced with Samsung Gear or Moto 360 smartwatches, which are location aware, to help the employees to automatically clock in when they enter the facility and clock out as soon as they leave. The smartwatches can also be used by employees to view details about their shifts without having the need to go to their computer, log into their accounts and check their shifts and the details. Trade shifts with other employees in case they need to change their shifts, which can be easily done through the smartwatches only. And again, manage their leaves. The app can also be used to measure the distance an employee travels on the shop floor and how much time is wasted in it. So how exactly does all this help the industry in bringing efficiency? The employees have no longer the opportunity to forget to punch in on time, as it will be done automatically. The employer will also know right away that they need to address an absence or an employee not coming on time, and hence minimizing downtime. Employers could also use the distance traveled information to reevaluate the path and locations within a factory that specific employees visit, in order to reduce excess travel across the factories. Next would be training and repair. Wearables are going to be the next thing in training. How? Learning while working. Wearables will take the trainees out of the confinement of classrooms to the actual work area. They will be better exposed to the work that they are expected to perform, and the training process will be faster. Normally, the trainees have to attend training sessions in a classroom, and then they are taken to the practical environment where they have to work what they have learned. So in manufacturing jobs, the potential roadblock to productivity new employees face is the computers. Even though they may be tech savvy, and yet they have to learn the software for recording work hours, entering data about new shipment of supplies, or recording defects, and all those stuff related to manufacturing. Removing employees from the training classroom and putting them on the factory floor speeds up the training process. The faster an employee learns how to use the machines in the real work environment, the faster they can accomplish the training work. So whether there is a new employee or a new machinery for which training is required, smart glasses can be used to reduce the time. So the technician has both hands free to try out the instructions on the videos being played on the smart glass. So how will this work? Another scenario we can see is, suppose we equip our warehouse staff with digital finger pointing devices and smart glass. The pointer allows them to point to any box and see barcode data about its content displayed on the glass. This will not only eliminate the need for them to open the boxes, examine the contents, and then input the details to the system, but also where all this could be done simply in a fraction of seconds. Smart glasses can also be used to improve the speed of the repair process. So if there is an issue with an equipment, employee can quickly click a picture and send it across to experts, and or maybe live stream the issue to the expert through the smart glasses. This way, the employee or intern can use the advice of experts from the shop floor itself. This will also be helpful for employees who are on field. Next is better visibility and control. To visibility in terms of tracking employees, keeping a track where an employee is positioned, which employee can be moved in case of emergency or any disruptions. Monitor productivity issues, less time is spent in collection and compiling of data, and line monitoring. Worker need not be tied to his workstation for long hours to monitor the assembly lines. Wearables can help in plant monitoring as well as employee monitoring. Wearables reduce the need for employees to be tied to their workstation for long to monitor the production line. Wearables enable them to monitor various aspects such as line, speed, temperatures and pressures or failures of any machine or equipment. In case of employee monitoring, imagine if we could measure the fatigue levels of an employee and schedule their breaks accordingly. This reduces the risk of any accidents or mishaps due to the lack of concentration or energy. Collectively speaking, all employees' wearable devices provides managers real-time information about the work that they are doing, what they are working on, with whom they are working on, if there are any production issues, if they are on schedule achieving their targets or before time or falling behind. All this data can help the managers in better decision making and faster decision makings. Next would be improving employee safety. Safety of employees is one of the key concerns in any of the manufacturing industries. Wearables have the capability of making the workplace accident proof by overriding human judgments. So wearables provide a hands-free environment for the employees to work. Employees will be able to operate machines from a distance. Smart bands or smart watches can be used to monitor the employees' biometrics and hence avoid occupational hazards. They can be used to measure the temperature, body pressures, or any other exposure to toxic gases. For those working in hazardous environment, mines, turbines, oil rigs, wearables could make a lot more safer to work. Helmets, watches, vests connected with sensors can alert employees to hazards. A use case I would like to point out here. Dump truck drivers in Rio Tinto coal mines in Hunter Valley are using a device called the smart caps to avoid fatigue-related accidents on the job. The smart cap is capable of conducting EEG tests on the wearer. This data helps in assessing the worker's alertness or ability to sleep. It also provides early warning to truck drivers approaching microsleeps and hence minimizing accidents due to fatigue. Next, we will be looking at some of the case studies or use cases where actually these wearables are being tested and being used to improve the production process. General Motors has created a solution with Google Class that hosts tutorials for employees to learn on the actual production line. As mentioned earlier in training and repair, General Motors focused on using technology to improve training. They worked with Plex Systems to integrate a solution that would host tutorials for employees to learn on the actual production line. GM is also experimenting with Google Glass as a way to improve the repair process. So if there is an issue with the equipment, employees can easily snap photos of the broken machine and share it, all without the use of their hands. In late 2015, Honeywell and Intel demonstrated a prototype of a personal connected safety solution that aims to reduce workplace injury and improve productivity. How is this done? The system is made up of a series of linked wearable sensors that measures a worker's breathing, heart rate, pressures, motion, and can detect whether someone has been exposed to toxic gases. The worker is meant to give plant managers and incident commanders the information needed to better anticipate unsafe conditions and prevent potential man-down scenarios that could threaten worker safety. BMW, again, is experimenting with a different piece of wearable technology for their factories, that is the chairless chair. Created by the Swiss startup Noni, the chairless chair is a piece of equipment that the employees can strap to their legs while they are moving, and that acts as a chair with a simple touch of a button. For factory workers, they have to stand for long durations, which affects their health, their postures, their backs, feet, legs, everything. So this unique piece of wearable technologies provides a solution to the lack of seating and breaks in the schedule. What is the future of these wearables? This is just the beginning. As wearables technology evolves, we are sure to see more manufacturers adopt the technologies to help plants become more safer and more efficient. Tesla, possibly one of the most technologically advanced auto manufacturers, is no stranger to trying new things. While many consumers didn't buy into Google Glass, Tesla is reportedly testing out enterprise editions for inventory management in its Fremont plant. So while there are a lot of benefits the wearable offers, there are a few concerns that needs to be handled. First is the safety concerns. Safety of the employees. So employees might take time getting used to the wearables. Physical injuries to employees should be taken care of. Malfunctioning of devices can cause physical or injuries or illness to the users. It takes time to adjust to a pair of glasses, and employees might hurt themselves in the training process itself. So before migrating to wearables, the prototype should be tested well. Employees must be given adequate training and clear safety and use instructions. And last but not least, their migration must be well planned and should be done in phases. Next would be the battery life. Power backup has become a challenge in manufacturing where people work for long hours without access to recharge points. Charging of wearables can be an issue, especially when employees are expected to use the device throughout their shifts. And most of these devices will be using either Bluetooth or location GPS or Wi-Fi connectivity, all of which require a good amount of battery life. Next is privacy issues, or let's say it as cyber risks. Like all devices, all modern technologies, even smart devices or wearables are bound to have these cyber risks. So they must be manufactured keeping in mind data security. If data transmitted through wearables are not secured, they could lead to unnecessary problems, losses, incorrect evaluations, and so on. As confidential data will be at risk, the data is stored in cloud and they are transferred through Bluetooth, so adequate security measures must be implemented. Besides these, cost of implementation might be another disadvantage. So these are just small hurdles which can be overcome with the correct implementation and understanding of the capabilities of wearables. Staying cutting edge does not have to stop on shop floors. We can make changes to the company process immediately. So with this, I'll hand over to Abhilash. Thank you for listening.
Thank you so much, Shruti. And we will now go ahead with some question and answers. We'll take some question Just a reminder, please be sure that you type your questions into the question box in your GoToWebinar control panel so that we can have them one after the other. Now, moving on to our first question. What are the other industries where wearables can play a transforming role? So what is your thought on that, Shruti?
I think apart from manufacturing, as I mentioned earlier, also healthcare and the service industry as well can use wearables. Service industry, as in one of the airlines is experimenting with glasses to customize their customer experiences. So as soon as passengers come at the desk to report, the glass gets information such as name and destination of the customers to the desk so that they can be more personalized while addressing the customers. Similarly, in even in medical cares also, these wearables are being used extensively these days.
Okay. Yeah, then moving on to our next question. Apart from increasing the efficiency of employees and improving the quality of products, what are the other advantages of wearables that we can have in an enterprise?
Wearables are definitely going to save a lot of time of employees, as they are not going to need to be, they don't need to enter data manually anymore to the system. All that will be done automatically through the smart devices or the wearables. So a lot of time is saved in terms of data entry. Okay. And again, we can easily view the data and make conclusions of the data on the go, okay, as and when required with the help of wearables.
Okay. I think that should be it for today. And thank you, Shruti. And thank you all for attending today's webinar. This is all the time that we had, and please look for the follow-up mail that will alert you on the on-demand status of the webinar so that you can review any material that you missed, or you can simply go over again. Any further queries will be taken offline. You can reach us at our social media pages, or you can simply drop us an email at webinar@cat.com. So this brings us to the end of the webinar. Apart from that, if you want to check out any of, if you want to find out any more information about wearables or about digital transformation as a whole, you can go to our website, suyati.com, and you can check out our resources. There are plenty of case studies, webinars, and white papers that you can check out, and you can find more information. So on behalf of Shruti and our entire team at Suyati Technologies, I thank you all for joining us today and taking your time to attend the webinar. We appreciate you being here. Have a good day. Thank you.